Hello, and it's here, and welcome to episode of Satisfactory. Well, I originally went out to see if I could use the scanner to get some doggos. But instead I found some slugs. So, well, that's 4 more power shards. But I also found this cave, which to go through the water to get into. So why don't we pop in and see what's around. Gotta swim. Oh balls. A lot of spiders. I need to pick up some more ammo later. Yeah. I think it's all of them. Go. And there's more around here somewhere. Hey, oh yeah, right there. Use all this to turn it into a DNA thing for more points. I strongly agree. Put it down. Hey, hey, hey. And we'll click this. There's still no use for these things. Harvest. There we go. Let's see, anything through this way? No. Okay. I guess that's everything here. Interesting little place. So I guess all we need to do is leave. Now look for another doggo. We need to increase the numbers. Now there's 2 isn't quite enough to get everything. Let's first find a way that I can get back easily. So we'll have to crouch in order to walk the dog back. Take a while. I'm gonna go back to the spots I found the other 2 and see if I can find more. If not, then I'll try looking for more locations. There is actually a map that exists that tells you where they all are. And since they do respawn after they die, I'm pretty sure they will respawn after you tame them. I don't think I saw one. I didn't. Alright, now we're here. Didn't really uncover much new over there, but never mind. I should find things I didn't see before. Now, where was a dog? Pretty sure there's one nearby. Was the one that was near the base? No, the old base. They forgot if anything near the new base. Gotta flow it. Hello? Kasakias, how did you get out? Come here, you silly little boy. Come on. How the frick did you get out? Oh, don't tell me Namakiri's also out. Silly little thing. How the frick did they manage that? I guess I might have to put a roof on. Maybe. Hey, come on, you silly little bugger. Getting back here, just dump a few things into there so they can be processed. Neat. And over here we go. Hello, Namakiri. It appears that Kasakias has found his way out. Silly little bugger. Okay, Kasakias. Time to get your little butt down here. That should be enough. Oh, some copper ore. That's what Kasakias found earlier. Neat. Silly little things. Now don't try and escape, okay? I might put walls around here just to make sure they can't get out. I don't know, they might just clip through the wall. Yeah, I might need to replace that wall of foundation. Anyway, all goes in there, that goes in there. That goes in there, that goes in there, that goes in there, that goes in there. Now all that stuff's gonna be taken out and sent to the right places. And then the flesh will be turned into protein and sent up to the sink, where the power shards will get put straight into there. Right. Let's go find a new one. So we have an additional doggy. Hopefully those buggers don't get out again. Let's do the replacing with the foundation first. Alright, that's everything put in place. We already found some wood. Interesting. Huh. Anyway, now we just need to head out. Hey, let's see, I'll deal with the wood later. For now though, I need to head to a spot where I found one of the dogs before. And see if there's a new one. If not, then we're going to have to search for a different one. And I have to find a map that has all of them marked. And then, once we got the doggo back, we focus on the actual task I want to do today. And what that is that task? Getting the computers set up. Get a whole crafting of them. At least 50. Oh, that said, it'll be a good idea. Let's just sit on this belt. Let's see if we can find a doggo. There is supposed to be one up here. That's why we found, I think it was Nevakiri. Doggo! It do respawn in the same spots. So as long as you're patient, you get lifted doggos from the same spot. Maybe I should really upgrade all of them to maximum. Oh well, I'm gonna have monorail soon enough anyway. Now I just need to slowly approach the doggo. Don't get too close though. Come on, doggo, don't keep moving. And I do believe this is a good spot. Doggo comes over here, it'll go after the berries. Now, come on, doggy, run over that way. Come on, silly little thing. Move closer. Just get a bit closer. Sneaky, 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 sneak. Come on, go get the berries. Oh, bugger ran off. Well, that's a little annoying. Look at this, he's running away. Where'd you go? There you are. See if you go towards that. Come on, turn around. Notice the berries. Ooh, doggy notice berries. Eee. There you go. You silly little thing. Hey, Samakuro. There we go. Now, Samakuro, how about we get you back? Luckily, we're not too far away. So if I keep going back here to get this, well, pretty much keep picking up the same one, Then it'll just be easy to fill up the ranch. Let's get tons of doggos. I feel like I might have been using up too much time on the doggos. Eh, oh well. Look what we got back. Nope. Nope. Creature in the way. The frick? How did Kasakias get out again? What a bugger. I gotta figure out where the bugger went. Come on, Namikiri. I kinda need you to move along. So I can put a ramp. Not sure what happened to Kasakias. Come on, buddy. No, buddy. Order save. And now we do that. And now you're both safe. Oh, well, that was sudden. Alright. Now I need to figure out where Kasakias went. Give me a moment. Alright, we are here. And I'm gonna find Kasakias. I was hoping I didn't despawn him simply because I got another one from the same place. That'd just be annoying. Yeah, extra crafting. This is where excess crafting stuff goes. Like excess screws, since I can't do them all in the same place because even the fastest belt in the game isn't quick enough for it. I didn't put a sign marking this. Whoops. I'm pretty sure I was going for these ones. That I was. There we go. Maybe let's choose layout to that one. Whoopsie. So image to screws. There we go. That's that one done. A bit blurry, but never mind. Oh, that ladder just, this door only lets you go to the other room. Yeah, I decided to raise this center bit of the roof a bit. Just by a little, not by much. Just to add a bit of style to it. Itty little, down to this floor. The copper and electronics. So, I guess I could keep making this longer, or I could put all the electronics on the other side. I was reserving the other side for the, manufacturer. I guess I just put the other stuff on there. It's not like it's the only one that's gone really far. But let's see. What do we need? Parts. So, our target is to have not only the supercomputer in production. Well, I guess that'll come a bit later. But our main focus is the computer, because we need that for the monorail. We have all but the first item. Which is a circuit board. So that'd be something we can do with. This also needs a high speed connector. It's not really needed for this for the computer. But it is needed for the supercomputer. So either way, the circuit board is the first one. Copper coil and plastic. But should I get the resonator done first? Let's see, where is it? This thing. Crystal oscillator. Yeah, I need that for quite a few research. So I guess I should just get the crystal oscillator in. Let's just do this one first. And to prevent this one from becoming like 1,000 miles over that direction, I'll use the other side. You know? Why not? It's there. But first, we need to figure out where the oscillator is going to be stored. Although, the first thing we can do is open up this space for it. Though it will need to be four because it does have... Wait a minute. Hold on a second. The frick did you just go? What did I press it on thing? Here we go. This needs the manufacturer. That doesn't. That does. And that does. Huh. So I'm guessing do with the manufacturer on this side. If I don't accidentally delete the one that's already there. There we go. Luckily for the oscillator, it's not going to be as messy as the bugger below. Anyway, let's get the walls in, and then we can get everything else on. Okay, that has now been set as a crystal oscillator. Now it's time for the mess of getting its resources in. Yay! Only three. That's fine. There we go. Splitter, you're a merger, you're a splitter. Let's get those all split in. So you go there. You like that. And you are like that. There we go. Now we put those into here like that. That to there. And that unfortunately cannot go down to like that. So we use this one instead. There we go. Mostly sorted. Hey, yep. The lowest tier is perfectly fine because it needs less than 20 or 2 of them per minute, and less than 5 of another. And this makes 2 crystal oscillators. So updating the sheet for the used section shouldn't be too bad, although they're reinforced. My place is going to get a bit weird. But 1 per minute. Oh, that's exactly the numbers I need to enter. If it makes 2 per recipe, but only 1 per minute, then it's already giving me all the numbers I need. I don't even have to worry about it increasing its speed until something starts using it. And I'm pretty sure it only starts using it in the alternative recipes. Anywho, why do we get a light in here? Yeah, rotate you to that. Nope. Press that one there. Alright. Left and right is perfect. Now let's see. Yeah, that's good. Rotate you. You. Now that will follow the same cycle as the other lights once it receives its first off command. No power. Oh, whoops. I want to put power into it. Did I open that one for the one below? Let's take a quick look. Pretty sure that's how I did it. If we can even see it. Yeah. Fine. That I did. I just simply upgrade it to the next tier when I need to expand it. Which will be soon. Now then, resources. The oscillator requires crystals. Which is right here. Yep, the crystal oscillator cable and the reinforced iron plate. Let's go into here, grab this. That will do. There we go. And because I gotta make sure everything coming in and out of storage is always at maximum speed, do that one. Alright then. Now then, next thing. The cables. Which comes from here. Yep, next cable's right here. If I'm not mistaken, the cables already go up. I can split it up there. Nope, wrong thing. Yeah, go back right there, so I don't need to worry about that one. Next is the reinforced plates. Which doesn't have an up. But now it will. Right here. No, not there. Almost the right place. Not quite, though. Yeah. over to the max levels. Do that one. Not really max level, but you know what I mean. Okay. Now we need to put the crystal oscillator storage down. Since it uses an item in stage 4, it will be a stage 5 item. And they organize. We get the industrial crate. We plop you right there. Buggering up. Not sure what mouse is doing. We get you. Okay, I think I went for a smaller one. You there. You there. And now, I want this. Layout will be this one. And the icon. I may as well just do the search, but I'm probably going to miss it a few times over. There we go. Crystal oscillator placed. Now we modify you. And we do the search again for the crystal oscillator. There we go. Storage now set. Now I just need to get it to go through the floors. Which here will do just nicely. There we go. Hey! Now that we've got everything sorted on the storage floor, let's head up to the copper and electronics floor. So we get this item being produced. Boing. So this is where the raw material is going to be coming in from. I don't want to make it that way just in case something else needs to come up here. But what I will do, we go that way. And I need to go get some more materials before I continue, because I don't have enough to continue for the belts. I just hope production's been high enough. Should be. Doesn't seem like it's actually making any more. Yeah. Oops. That'll do. Probably a lot more than I need, but still. May as well be prepared. It is always better to have it and not need it than to need it and not have it. Pretty sure you guys have heard that one plenty of times already. Turn you that away, move you closer that away. Perfect. That's right here. In goes the crystal oscillator. And the crystal quartz. You're probably going to the slow belt once I get into here. Now then, one thing I forgot to do on this end is the merge. You get to extend it. Oh, I put this in to go to the edge, did I? Oops. Ah, I didn't give a lot of space there, did I? So I found the same spot. Oh, I see what went wrong. It's like half nudge that way, then it is that way. You need to do a half nudge that way to get in the same spot. That's a pain in the butt. Well, if we move that, we get a roof. Move that. No, they are actually in the same place. Huh. Guess I was wrong. Oh well. Keep you back there, turn up the soup, because I don't need soup. Alright, that's that back in place. Now they've got one of the ingredients for the oscillator. Let's get some splitters in place for the next set of ingredients. Although, if that's where the product is going to, and this is the other item it needs. So let's do this one first. Put you on there like that. Then I'll have you come. Now if I put it over here, it might actually block another one coming up. You know, do a bit of future proofing by not having it potentially stop another one from reaching this floor. Like that one does. No, wait, I think that one actually is at the beginning of its line. No. This is where screws would come up. Oh, some of the items are going to be baking these screws. I have to adjust that. Alright. Come right over here with it. Pop you here. And then we'll go this way. Whee! Boing. And a boy. Oh, buggering hell. As far as it goes this way. Now, in order to make sure it can go up to where it needs to be, now the next one. I remember the best spot. Okay. Maybe like that on this line. And we'll grab this. Rotate. Go over here. And up left. Now we're from here to there. Go from there, over there, and awesome. Ingredient number two is now going in. The last thing we need is the cable. Now with the cable, we'll be doing a splitter. But it's already coming up here. Right here. The best way to do this splitter for this or what? Oh wait. Yeah, I'm gonna need to rotate this thing. Yeah, I mean. Because if we go into parts, go all the way down to the computer, you see it uses screws. And since the screws, well, the computer's being built on this floor, I'm gonna need to, you know. I'm gonna, like, move this belt. This doesn't need screws. This doesn't. This does. What about you? You don't need any. Yeah, I'm gonna need to move the belt so I can get the screws up here. Which means I need even more rods. You see, even more screws coming down here. Oh, man. Well, the only thing I can do is break it down and rearrange everything. You there like that. Now I'll go back. Go to the first page. Put down a splitter. Right in the middle here should be just fine. Back to this one. You go there. Then bring you over here. It's facing the right way. Now it's lined up with that one. Was it straight? It is. Now this one, go all the way down there. Now I can get this one, and move it all the way over here. Now before I compare it all the way, I'll make it go here first. Next thing I'll do... you. There's usually a good spot. I have to give it a quick check before I finalize. No, it needs to be one over. And get you out again. Copy that. There we go. And now, I just need to put down a few more of those things. First one will be in line with this here. Next one will just be put on top of that. You will head over to this end like that. And then you will head up to this one, like that. And then finally you'll go over there. Now then, one thing I haven't put down just yet. The sign. Now that one's too small. This one. I don't remember the exact position I put it in line with the one below it. But I think right in the middle will do. Do you, layout, do that one, back to the elements, do this one. Yeah. Crystal oscillator, there, done. Okay, now we gotta do is export the crystal oscillator. Simple enough. that there, move it up to the top, and boom. Alright, now where is the destination? It is all the way over here. Now to prevent it from clogging up any other things, like that. And this will come out this way. I guess it's bigger all the way over there for now. And maybe look at this. Yeah, like if anything comes up around here. Yeah, let's just make it this way. All the way to the end. Too long. There, like that. Get that straight. That'll do. No, we're in hell. You auto save. Oh, it's generating a bit of lag. Kind of annoying. What are we gonna do? That's good. Yep. And connect. Now, whenever this bugger finishes a product, take freaking ages though, it will simply. Oh man. I really did bring out enough, didn't I? Huh. See, whenever it's done, it'll just go up and go straight in. And then when there's enough crystal oscillators, we can finish more research at the MAM. But for now, we need to do another project. Which is the circuit boards, which require the copper sheets and the plastic, which if I'm not mistaken, copper sheets are already on this floor. And you see right here. It's just gonna be a little awkward to set it all up. Oh my. Especially now that I need to put a hole here. Fortunately though, not mistaken, that only has two material requirements, so it's not going to be as messy. Yeah, just two. It's going to be a lot simpler, cleaner to do than the rest of these buggers are going to be. Hey, fresh new flooring. Go there like that, and slap you across like that. Bring it back there like that. Beam of grass, and do that. Okay, now we do that, and do that. And put that there, that there, that there. I'm out of concrete. Alright, that's that power line connected. We're not connected over here, but unfortunately that has no more lines available. So, we improve it. A simple and easy little task. No. Now let's get the light on. Guys, right now! And let's see, not that way, but this way. Is it in place? There we go. Good from you. Over. Oh, there we go. All these have to be the second level. Anyway, though. Let's focus on getting the assembler in place. I just need to remind myself the exact locations I put these things. Look, we've got plenty of them over here. What are you, though? This one. Boing. Alright, so that bit goes right there. Alright, good enough. Let's get it in the correct position, so there's plenty of room for the splitters and everything. And there we go. Wait, did I put it in the right place? I'm a little concerned that I might put it in the wrong spot. There really isn't that much time, right? Oh my. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. I'm putting this smooth like that. Anyway, let's head over here and get this thing set up to make the item that I want it to. Bloody hell, autosave. Stop doing that. It's better than losing everything, but still, it's a pain in the butt. Circuit boards. Here we go. Now, time for splitters and mergers. Yep, that goes fine right about there. And the next one will be fine right about here. That's good. Now we need a merger. I'm ready for rods. Not that I can really pick up any more right now. Because I don't have enough of them coming in. Let's connect these up. Then we'll check the standard processing speed. Yeah, this Mark 1s will be good enough. I'm going to have to go through and sort out all of my processing, because the cover sheets is currently producing the exact amount being used. But this is, requires 15 more a minute. Yeah. Makes one every 7.5 per minute. Mm. Anyway, yeah, that should be easy to calculate because it's just these 2 per 1. These 4 per 1. Yeah, easy to do. Anyway, though. The copper sheets, the ones being used are over here. Okay. That one. This one. Now that. I think I might best get rid of this one. And that one. And that one. Now let's see if I can set a splitter in the exact same position. You'll connect directly with that, which is good. I'm not sure if that'll automatically link them up. That might be a bit too close. If they're automatically connected, and it'll go straight in, then that's good. Yeah, the belt will go along there just fine. That's fine. There we go. Unfortunately, they're not connected to each other, so if I get rid of this, then put that on like that. That should extend. There we go. Now we just need this one to connect. Which we'll do by raising up by 2 bits. Nope, not that one. Going in here. Put that there. Should be good enough. Yeah, that'll do. That will do. There we go, that's sorted. Now I have space underneath it to bring over here. Right, I need to pick it up. And then it goes up by... nice. Bounce over. Put this here. Go up again. I think I might have it going to this one. Oh, I don't have enough materials for the belts. Me. I might as well put down a container for it too. Hmm. The highest level of processing is going to be the copper sheets. It will probably be an early stage one. Hey. Well, let's go down. Yeah, it's going to be these ones. You can see, the sheets, which is the highest tier it needs, is right there. So, let's get its storage put in place. Like that. Head back. Bloody hell. Autosave's always getting me like that. Alright. Layout. Elements. Ooh. That's finding the damn bugger. Well, not. At least I now know these will be fully automated and I won't have to worry about getting them crafted myself. And there we go. Nope. For the conveyor system. just to so that can go like that. And that will connect directly to it. There you go. Put all items into here. Now, over to the plastic. That is currently being unused. Let's go down like that. And that can go up like that. So now plastic is being provided. Yeah. Let's head back up. Alright, plastic's being provided right here. I think the best way to get it in is have it going this way first. Have it come a little bit over this way. Do that. See, it's already full of plastic. Now we bring it all the way over this way. And I think... let's say he will do just fine. A little bit too far that way. There we go. Then we can continue bring that this away. And I think here will do. And then just go straight around like that. Alright. Plastic has been connected and is now being inserted. Alright. It's time for you to get inserted. Just in case I need to split it, I'll do this. First of all, make sure it's in the right spot. No, it's not. I need to move it along by one. Like that. And now, is that good? That it is. And now one final piece before we get it done is right there. That'd be a good spot. Yeah, I think that'll do. Oh, it's a bit wonky. Let's stop it. Fine. Here we are. And now it's time to get this into its storage. That's a tad bit awkward. Especially considering that, it needs to get over there. I think it might be best if I have it go a little lower. One or two lower. Do that. Just to make sure it's not going too far down. Like that. I think that's a good spot. Okay. And now? Like that. And boom. There we go. Now all the products can be put in. I do have one on me. Not sure I'll ever need it. Not sure what exactly happened there. Alright. And there goes a bunch. Wasn't really expecting that to mess up like that. Unfortunately, we have actually run out of time. Yeah. Have to do some optimizations. Well, before we end the video, let's head back to Namakiri and Samakuro. And then try and figure out where Kasakias went. Yeah, just see what the little buggers have brought back. Alright, you two. Oh, Kasakias went. Okay, Namakiri hasn't found anything yet. What about you, Samakuro? Oh, you found some berries! Nice. Yeah, I haven't seen Kasakias. A bit odd. Strange. Anyway, I'm gonna take these power shots that I do have. Oh, four of them, and improve a few things. Although I gotta update the whole thing first. Need to add the two new items to my spreadsheet. Where would he be? I need to check on the wiki to see if taming the same a dog up in the same place causes your early one to despawn. Really suck if that is the case. Anyway, I hope you will enjoy this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.